Hello everybody, welcome back. We got the new video, new week, and one extra fresh new cocktail to learn. Today I'm going to show you again, after the last week episode, how you can develop your skill of learning cocktail and to making that cocktail with a style while you're staying at home. Okay, so then when you come back to the work again, you're gonna be able to remember more recipes, and then you're gonna have still the skills even on a better level than you had before. Let's get straight away into it. Okay, so today we going to learn three things: little bit of the cocktail, little how to make the cocktail, and how to create like a little routine to cocktail to remember it. So let's go to the first thing. And we're going to learn about the cocktail Mary Pickford. While you're staying at home, you have many opportunities to learn something about it. So I will suggest you, whilst you're learning how to make a drink, always remember or try to learn something, at least one little thing about the cocktail. This cocktail is kind of easy to remember because it's Mary Pickford and is named after Canadian American actress, which she was traveling with Charlie Chaplin around the Cuba, around the Havana in early 1920s or late 1920s, around 1920s. And two gentlemen, I don't remember their name because they're really difficult name to remember, but two gentlemen kind of created this cocktail for her, which was based on light rum, fresh pineapple juice, and dash of grenadine. In this time, we know this recipe just exactly how it was, but it's refreshed with a 1 spoon or dash extra of maraschino liqueur, okay? That is our history of the cocktail, so we know something interesting which you can help you to communicate with your customer. And now we come into the cocktail recipe. We got 50 ml of white rum, 25 ml of pineapple juice, 1 dash of grenadine, and 1 spoon of maraschino. It coming to the martini glass, it's shaken and a strain. That's my first time I read the cocktail. Now I'm going to prepare my ingredients. So the second time I'm gonna come up with the recipe again will be 50 ml of light rum, 25 ml of pineapple juice, 1 dash of grenadine, and 1 spoon of maraschino liqueur. Okay, so I got my bottles ready. Okay, and now I have to come up with a routine, but first I need to make the drink. So let's make a drink the easiest way as possible. So we need 50 ml of light rum. 50 ml of light rum is in there. Now we need 25 ml of pineapple juice. It's in there. Now we need 1 dash of grenadine. Excuse me. Dash should be there. I put it just basically a little bit more because it's a water, but don't be scared, because when you're gonna be working with the syrup is more thicker, and so you're gonna have exact dash how you want it. And now let's put the jigger away. Now we need 1 spoon of maraschino, which we're gonna use bar spoon, and we put 1 spoon of maraschino. Normally it's like a little dash, but you can play with that spoon. You can stir it a little bit before you're shaking it, okay? And respect the recipe as well, of course. Now we need to ice it up and shake it and strain it into martini glass. And now is the time when you're gonna put it into the another level. You put another gear, okay? So you're going to play with your tin. Now we're going for a roll to your left hand. And now we're gonna start with the same kind of routine like we did before. Stall bottle around your hand, okay? Now you're going to start doing these circles. So you catch your bottle in a way to do the circle in the neck, okay? In your tennis grip. And then you basically just doing the circle. Now we're going to change the hands, basically exchange the tin for a different hand. So just like that, okay? So let's start again. So exchange the hands, and now you do half spin with the tin, okay, to ready to snatch. Now we're going to continue the circle, okay? And now we're going to snatch in a half wheel circle, okay? So just like that, you make the sound, customers get more attention, and it brings more crowd for you. Then you're going to flat throw it, let them go, okay? I love to do this release that you separate the bottle and the tin, okay? But this comes with practice. So what you can do is just let them go, okay? Or maybe just hold the tin for a half second so the bottle goes up, okay? Not like that, but just like that. It separates, okay? When it separates, you just grab the tin with your left hand, that's the left hand, and then you're holding bottle in your right hand with the beer grip in cross hands position, okay? Now we're going to start pouring. But before, let's try the beginning of that routine in a slow motion, okay? So 3, 2, 1. There we go, and now we start pouring. Turn around, now behind the head with the double spin, and continue pouring, finish. There you go, bring it here on a barter. Now we're going for our pineapple juice, where we need the jigger. So I need a thumb roll with the jigger to hold in it like this. But I'm not gonna be pouring just like that, okay? So I wanna be the style. So if I'm in here and I'm gonna be pouring like that. So when I'm doing the thumb roll, so I try to, as soon as it's finishing, instead of catching it like this, I try to catch in between these two fingers, the middle finger and the index finger, so I can be ready to pour straight away. So let's try it. That didn't work. Let's try it again. We practice, it doesn't matter, no? There we go. We got it there. Now we need the pineapple juice. So let's say, twist the bottle and do like a wow effect, okay? Wow. There you go. And we pour. We practice our jigger. There we go. Now we need a dash of grenadine. I remember recipe. I don't need to even look at it. So dash can be stylish. So let's say I got a small bottle for a grenadine now. So it's like a Angostura or the bitter bottle. So we can do something like stylish for a dash. So let's say, yeah, more like this. So this move is basically starting with kind of pointing like a gun, okay? And then you bring in it around, okay? And you just feeling basically these two fingers. When it comes to this position, you're just pushing away the bottle, and with these fingers you put it up and try to twist it and to make it like a stylish thing, okay? So you can use that even for a pour. So you're holding it like this, and you see, you're pouring in this position. So just like that, okay? So that will be our dash. Let's say, dash, bring it back. In the same way like you started, same way, around the tin. It looks really, really cool. What we need now, spoon of maraschino. So let's give a spoon a journey, okay? So we're gonna do the classic finger roll from this position, twist it, and then pushing it out with the ring finger up. Give it from this position to here, just a journey from right to left. Now we put it a little bit, you touch it on the bar top, so it's stable. And now you're switching for the same beginning, okay? While you're switching, you can grab the bottle for your maraschino. And now you're going to do one, and now you're catching it. When you finish the finger roll, you holding it and you basically fix it with your ring finger. And now it's ready to get that maraschino inside of it. There we go. Now we can spit it, leave the rest of the drops inside of it. Now we can put it down again, and now we can exchange the hands and do finger roll on the way back. And like this, you give a spoon the journey. So, finger roll this way, change, finger roll here, spoon, stir. There we go, put it here, change the hands. Okay, you can do it faster, so don't worry if you do it in a half second, spoon never drop. Okay, now we got all the ingredients. Now we can do little move with the tin. Okay, ice it and shake it. All right, so I will say now we made this cocktail about 5 times and now we're ready to play some music and get ready to rock the routine which we learn right now.
She's the gal that I love best. To the food, home rude. To the food, woo. To the food, home rude. To the food, home rude. To the food, home rude. A womp, bump, a loom, bump, a lump, bump, bump. Got a gal named Daisy. She almost drives me crazy. I got a gal named Daisy. She almost drives me crazy. She knows I love me, yeah.
And that was our Mary Pickford. So I believe I'm gonna remember that Mary Pickford. I know the little bit of the history, and I know how to play with it. And I'm gonna practice this routine over and over and over. And probably, even if you're not gonna remember the routine, you're gonna remember just a little bit about the cocktail. And with this way, you can every day develop your flair skills and your recipe skills and your knowledge basically about the cocktails. If you have any suggestions or any ideas what we can make it better and what I should do, just write it in the comments below and put it subscribe. One more time, thank you very much. Be safe and keep practicing. See you later.